Good evening, YouTube. It has been a long time. I knew I said I wasn't going to make a video until spring, but I figured, what the heck. Felt like it's just been too long. Figured I'd go for a walk. I'm going to walk downtown and get a bite to eat. Got a pretty good Chinese buffet down there. The reason I decided to make the video is I wanted to talk about a couple of things and maybe even show you the town, but it might be a little bit too late to do that now. I haven't done much. It's been a crazy winter. We got a bunch of snow, like, right before Christmas, and then immediately after New Year, it all melted away. It went up to about 40 degrees for about 3 days. And then it dropped back down into the teens, and it's pretty much leveled off there, but it hasn't snowed again. We got basically just little dustings of snow, so it's been strange. Normally we get more snow than this. Also, the other reason it's been crazy is because at work we had two people just suddenly quit, which has left a big gaping hole in our ability to provide for our customers. So everybody has been working a crap load of overtime. I worked 6 days straight, had 1 day off, and then worked 5 days. And now I got 2 days off, and then I'm working 4 days straight. So it's been weird. But hey, overtime, I love overtime. Money, 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 money. Gives me a lot of extra cash to do things I've been wanting to do. And on that note, I got to thinking about the Queen and everything that I need to do this coming season to get her fixed up. And I started to wonder what's worth doing, what isn't worth doing, and that kind of thing. And I've actually come up with an interesting thought. As much as I enjoy the Queen, and I like it, it's in good shape, I've done a lot of work, put a lot into it, I'm starting to wonder if it's really what's best for me. I'm actually thinking I might be interested in selling her and getting another van with a better layout. Truth be told, I don't really like the big bed in the back, it takes up a lot of space. I don't like that there's nothing over the driver, it leaves me with very little, that just seems like a lot of wasted space. Additionally, I want a flush toilet. I've already talked about that endlessly, which I can do, but it's kind of a hassle. Also, I want an awning. This thing doesn't have an awning. Again, I could put one on, but that's quite a bit of money for a decent one. So anyway, what I'm thinking is, I haven't decided fully, but what I'm thinking is I might like to put the Queen up for sale and get instead a early to mid, maybe to late, I don't know how long into the 90s they made them, but early to late 90s Coachman built on the Ford chassis. I'm sure you've all seen them. I really like the layout of that one better, with the bathroom in the rear, with the little tub and the actual flush toilet, and then the couch that folds down, as well as the pull-out bed over the driver. Additionally, what I like about that is that the two side doors both open. They put the fridge further back, and so the side door opens, which allows a lot more light and ventilation, which I really like. I really don't like the fact that the Queen only has the one side door and that they've sealed the other door closed. I really don't care for that, but there's nothing I can do to change that. Well, I mean, there is, but it's not worth doing. I'm not gonna do it. the only reason I'm really hesitating to do it is because, for God's sake, the Queen has a brand new engine. I'm never gonna find another van with a brand new engine. But I guess it's worth considering, because even if I can get one with, say, 50 to 70,000 miles on it, I put maybe 3,000 miles a year on the van, so that'll last me forever. And if I keep it in nice shape, if the engine ever does go bad, I can do exactly what I did with the Queen, put a new engine in. So, yeah, haven't fully decided yet, but I figure I'll put it out there, because if any of you want to make me an offer on the Queen, like a serious offer, if you really want to buy her, send me a message. I'll put my email in the description below. Email me. You can ask me questions if you'd like. and maybe make me an offer. Basically, I want to just see what I can realistically get for her. I know I've talked about my doubts about her value for quite a bit. Some people say she's worth a lot. I'm not so sure. But I want to put it out here on YouTube first and give my followers the first chance to buy her. I don't want to advertise her yet. Another thing I wanted to talk about was the music in my videos. Up until now, all I've used is the YouTube audio library, because I know that if you use just any song you want, they can sometimes take your video down for copyright things. I've seen videos, a lot of videos, from people using songs from famous artists. One that comes to mind is the video that cop singing Mariah Carey in the squad car. It was really funny. But I got to thinking, how come he can put Mariah Carey in his video, but I can't? Not that I want to, but the point stands. And so I started doing research, and I found out that YouTube actually has agreements with a lot of artists about, YouTube has agreements with a lot of artists, and they have a long list of songs that you can put on your video, but most of them, you cannot monetize your video when you use their music. And that means that you cannot receive advertising revenue or anything from your videos. And so I was conflicted on whether or not I wanted to do it, because I want to put better music in my videos, because I don't really care for the audio library. I think expanding my music capabilities would improve my videos dramatically. However, I wasn't sure I wanted to give up monetizing, and then I started to do a little more research into my statistics, or whatever you call it, and basically I've been on YouTube now for almost a year, and I've made from my monetized videos $100. Not exactly rolling in the dough here. So I said, I'm not in this for the money, screw the money. I'm just doing this for fun. So I'm gonna go ahead and demonetize my video and use whatever music I want to. I mean, keeping within the list that YouTube has. Because there are still some songs and by some artists that you cannot use at all, no matter what. They will shut your video down. But most of the time, it'll be fine. So in future videos, hopefully I'll have better music and it'll be more entertaining, and to hell with the money, I guess. Because it's not really any money. All right, just had a great meal. Good eatin's. The Jade Buffet here in town. I don't know why, but I start coughing every time I finish eating there. Maybe because I eat too much. It's the curse of buffets. Always overeat at a buffet. Damn. I'm okay. I'll live. Oh, boy. Anyway, I wanted to discuss another thing. I wanted to get your opinions on whether or not I should start one of those GoFundMe or GoFund yourself or whatever thing is, so that people can donate and contribute to the budget for maintenance and upgrades on the Queen and or whatever other van I get. I've thought about this before, but I haven't done it because I've heard of a lot of people criticizing YouTubers for e-begging, which seems ridiculous to me because I'm not begging anybody. I'm not taking anybody's money. I'm not forcing anybody to give it to me. I'm not saying, if you don't contribute to this, I'll stop making videos or whatever. No, none of that's happening. I will continue to make videos. I will continue to travel. I will continue to do upgrades and repairs and things like that, whether people donate or not. Nothing's going to change. The only thing that will change is if people choose to donate, and enough people choose to donate, the upgrades and repairs and videos will come faster. Because obviously I'm not going to make a video unless I have something to show you. And the more money I have, the more often I will have things to show you. So I'd be interested to hear your opinions on whether or not that's something I should do. I could also create some kind of a Amazon... Oh crap, it's too loud here. I could also create some kind of an Amazon wish list that people could go and find something that they want to buy and buy it, and it'll be sent to me. That's an option as well. I'm not sure if I want to do it or not. So let me know what you think. Just down in the comments below. Okay, just a couple more things, and then that should conclude this video. I also wanted to hear people's opinion on what this channel should be, because I've gotten more than one request from folks who want me to vlog other things in my life. They want me to record myself at work. They want to see what I do for a living. They want to, you know, that kind of thing. They want to see more of Frank and me in our daily lives. And I've considered that as well, but I'm not sure if that's going to be interesting to enough people to do so. Because my life is fairly redundant, should I say. I don't go over the road trucking anymore, so I'm pretty much going to the same places over and over and over again. It is different every day, but we have the same pool of customers that we go to. So I just don't know if there's enough material there for it to be interesting for very long, at least. And I'm pretty much, I work at night as well, so that's another problem. It's gonna be dark in the cab most of the time. It's gonna be tough to film in the dark. I suppose I could turn the light on overhead, but I don't know. Anyway, that was the other question. Do you want to see more than just African Queen camping type stuff? If so, I have no problem with that. I can make videos if that's something you all want to see. And also, I wanted to clarify... Oh, excuse me. I wanted to clarify also what I'm looking for in a replacement for the Queen if I do indeed decide to replace her. I said the coachman was at the forefront of my thought, because that's the one that seems to fit me perfectly. However, Airstream also made one, or at least put their name on one, that is very similar around that same era. I really like that one too. It looks like it's got a bigger top on it, like it's wider, so that might make for a little bit more space inside. But those are also very rare, and I suspect kind of expensive. But that's something I would definitely like. There are really only a handful of things that I'm requiring in a replacement for the Queen. One would be low mileage. Two would be up-to-date, modern equipment such as fuel injection, four-speed transmission with overdrive, that kind of thing. That's why I don't want to go any older than like 92 or 93, because the Queen is a 96. So going much older than that would kind of be a step down. I want to stay right around that same age or newer. Thirdly, or whatever, forget the numbers. I also want a flush toilet. I've made that very clear. If there is no flush toilet, I'm not interested. I know people do other things, composting toilets, and a couple people have even suggested just pull that toilet out and just use a bucket. I don't want to use a bucket. If I was interested in living that way, I'd just use a tent. I want the comforts of home while I travel. I'm a first world kind of guy. I like modern comforts, which is why I picked an RV instead of just a van. So I want a flush toilet with a holding tank, not recirculating. I also want a shower. If it doesn't have a shower, I'm not interested. Make that very clear as well. Also, a couch, not a dinette. I do not want a dinette. I want a couch. Dinettes, I find, are very uncomfortable and not very useful. Let's see, what else? Those are the only real main things. I mean, there are a few other smaller things that aren't really worth mentioning that I want but could probably live without. But those are the main things that I absolutely will not consider if it does not have all those things. Class B is what I want, but I'll also consider small Class C. Like those Toyota ones with the Toyota cab, I'm interested in those. Those I know will get really good mileage and are fairly highly sought after and pretty well made. The problem with a Class C, in my experience, is that they always leak. Every single Class C I have ever seen has leaked at some point in its life, particularly over the driver. I don't know what it is about that over the driver part that it always freaking leaks. My father's RV, I believe, is a 99, late 90s anyway. He bought it, it was quite expensive, barely used, and it had already had the cab above the cab area sealed once before, and it had started leaking again, and it had destroyed, it's destroyed the structure above the cab in his nice, very expensive new RV. So now he has to deal with that and get all that fixed, and it's going to be a pain in the butt. And so that's one of the reasons I'm not really crazy about the idea of a Class C, because all that wood and everything, tendency to leak. Class B has a metal body with a fiberglass top. There's very little structure in there that can rot, which is why I like it. The Queen has leaked. Clearly has some water damage in certain parts of it, but all the wood that's in there is pretty much just cosmetic. There's no structure. So if the water does get in, it's not going to ruin it. It's just going to make a little bit of damage. You replace a little bit of wood and you're done. But mine haven't had enough to change anything. There isn't even enough damage inside to replace any of the wood. So I'm not bothering. Hang on, it's loud again. Boy. I gotta get a better camera system. I gotta get a stabilizer. I gotta get better microphone. Because I'm sure this is not working very well. Okay, it's obviously getting dark. I don't even know how much of me you can see. So I'm gonna wrap this up. To summarize everything, if you wanna make an offer on the Queen, feel free. I haven't fully decided to sell yet. If you have an RV that's similar to what I've described, that you might be interested in trading, I can also open to those offers. If you know of one that is for sale that fits my description, let me know. I don't know exactly how much I'm willing to spend, but I'm kind of looking between anywhere between 8 and 12,000, because that's what I think the Queen is worth. I'm kind of hoping I can exchange it, basically sell the Queen, buy another one, and come up financially neutral. So make me an offer if you're interested. And let me know what I should be doing as far as video making. Should I stick to camper van videos? Or should I broaden my spectrum to life vlogging? And what was the other thing? Oh, and let me know what your opinion is on whether or not I should open up the options for people to contribute / donate / whatever you want to say, whether or not that's worth doing. Or if it's something I should avoid like poison, because it does seem to be the downfall of some YouTubers who shall remain nameless. That's all for now. I don't know when I'll make another video. It might not be till spring. Or, actually, it'll probably happen if I do anything with the Queen before spring. That's when it'll happen. So, take care, everybody. I hope you're all having a wonderful winter so far. And I will see you next time.